Let me go ahead and start this segment with a bit of a language warning, because there is some very colorful language here from Fox News host Mark Levin. I am not going to censor myself on any of it, so if you have an aversion, or if you're listening to this or, you know, on a in a public area with your volume up, you may want to turn it down just a little bit. Having said that, here we go. Fox News host Mark Levin took to social media the other day to rant and rave like a lunatic about reports that President Biden has used profanity to describe both Donald Trump and Benjamin Netanyahu. In fact, he called Netanyahu a bad fucking guy, and he called Trump a sick fuck. Now, the Trump thing was said in reference to Trump reveling in the misery of others, particularly related to the hammer attack on Nancy Pelosi's husband, which Trump publicly jokes about to this day. So, given the two, I'm going to say, like, yeah, Biden is correct for doing that. And let's not forget, by the way, that Netanyahu actually tried to tank the Iran deal that President Obama put in place, came to Congress to lobby against it. So, yeah, plus everything else. But Mark Levin got so worked up over these reports that Biden is saying these things privately. Okay, Biden has not said any of these publicly. These are things that he is allegedly saying to people behind closed doors where nobody but his friends and close allies can hear him. And little snowflake Mark Levin can't stand it. So Levin got on social media and said this. Actually, Biden, you're the f***ing piece of shit, not Netanyahu and not Trump. You've blood on your hands on our border in Israel and Afghanistan and among our own troops. You and your family used your public office to make tens of millions from our enemies. Your foul-mouthed attacks against others further shows what a sleazy head case you truly are. Sickening. Okay, that's a big response there, Levin. I mean, these are just reportedly things that Biden has said. I mean, he hasn't said them on the record. He's not saying them publicly. And if you're going to act like Donald Trump doesn't do the same thing, or that Marjorie Taylor Greene or any of these other Republicans out there aren't doing some of these things, but publicly, then you're an absolute liar. I mean, Marjorie Taylor Greene posted a video a year or two ago, I guess it was. She was in the middle of a workout. And she's filming herself, and she stops in the middle of the workout, walks up to the camera and says, Joe Biden, you're a piece of shit. Like, that's it. That's the video. And she posted that for the world to see. Where were you there, Mark Levin, huh? You didn't attack the foul mouth attacked from a Republican lawmaker against the sitting president of the United States. But now we get a couple reports saying Biden may be saying things like this behind closed doors, and suddenly your fragile little ears can't handle it? Grow the hell up. Stop being offended by stupid things. I mean, I guess that goes to the entire Republican Party, right? The party that boycotted Bud Light, that boycotted the NFL over Colin Kaepernick taking a knee during the national anthem. The party that blew up their Yeti coolers because they wouldn't give NRA discounts anymore. The party that was, you know, throwing their Keurigs off the balconies and lighting fire to their Nikes. And mad about Dr. Seuss and so many other things. You're mad that the M&Ms aren't sexy enough for you anymore. Can Republicans please, for the love of God, for 1 minute, stop freaking out about stupid things? We all know the answer to that. The answer is no, but sometimes it's fun to watch them freak out just to be reminded of who the snowflakes really are. Well, folks, we have crossed that 1 million subscriber milestone, but rest assured, we are just getting started here at Ring of Fire. So if you're not already, please do subscribe to the channel and make sure to like, share, and comment on the videos.